And now, friends and foes, it's time for Cooking Time with Rachel.
Today, we're going to have a guest cook. Are you ready? It's my best friend, Miranda. She's going to be here in about 30 minutes, and we're going to get started when she gets here because she's bringing the rice. But we are making teriyaki chicken and rice, fried rice and vegetables. Right. We have our chicken that has been defrosted because we only use freezer chicken because that's what we can get right now at Kroger. Or at the grocery store. Sorry. If you want to have raw chicken, go ahead and cut that up. We're going to look for 1-inch chunks. We're going to heat up our pan with some oil inside it so we can pan sear it. And then we're going to cook it. Make sure your chicken bites, like your pieces of chicken, get to reach 165 internal temperature. That is very important, one. And two, we are going to be using teriyaki sauce or marinade on it. You can get the really thin teriyaki like sauce on it. That's fine. You do you. But I did get a teriyaki marinade, and I'm gonna use that instead. This one has pineapple juice, so it's got a little bit more twang to it. And I did say twang and not tang. But yes, we are making teriyaki chicken, and we are basically waiting for our guest chef to come with the rice. So we are going to slowly, we're going to pan sear our chicken and then cook it because we want to reach the internal temperature of 165. Very important thing to remember when you're pan searing things or like any pan searing any meat, make sure the meat is very dry, especially if you're not going to put a coating on it. I don't put coatings on my stuff. My husband and I try and eat lower carbs, higher protein, so we don't add extra flours when we don't have to. Not that we're allergic to gluten or anything, we just prefer not to. But make sure your meat's very, very dry. And also make sure you don't overcrowd your meat. If you overcrowd your meat, it's going to lower the temperature of your oil and you're not going to get a good sear on it. So those two things, remember, dry meat, dry your meat, and don't overcrowd your pan, all right? You want them nice and social distanced through this time of life. I realized what was messing with Cooking Time with Rachel. Rachel's really cute aprons. Isn't this one cute? We're waiting for our oil to heat up so we can pan sear our chicken. We will have a raw chicken station, the pan searing, and then a cooked chicken station. And we're gonna go like that. Once all the chicken has been pan seared, then we're gonna return it all to the heat and get the temperature to 165. And remember, internal temperature 165. When it reaches that internal temperature 165, then we're gonna add the marinade, put the temperature on low, and just kind of let it all simmer together until we put together our rice and vegetables. Gotta remember our vegetables. Folks, remember I told you a guest chef was gonna be in the kitchen with
I'm
me.
sorry.
That's
who,
okay.
where are you cooking at?
I'm just recording. Hi.
Oh.
Hi, guest chef Miranda, best friend. She's making the rice with the vegetables to go with our teriyaki chicken. So the chicken's been in the pan. We've pan seared it all, and then we put it back in. We're trying to get that internal temperature to 165, and then we're gonna add the sauce to the chicken, and we're waiting for the water to boil for the rice.
Cheers.
Sounds good. We've got our chicken and teriyaki sauce. I've added the frozen broccoli to that and kind of letting it marinate in there. And then we've just covered our rice to cook for 20 minutes. So we'll check back in 20. Finished teriyaki chicken, broccoli, and rice. It smells so good. Definitely 10 out of 10 would do this again.